गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग एक्सरसाइज 10.2। वी हैव डिस्कस्ड 8 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 9। क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 इज फिगर इज गिवन। Is given to you. There are the chord XY and X dash Y dash. Circle is there. Tangents are there. X dash, Y dash, and XY are the tangents at the point P and Q. This is the diameter P O Q. There is one line which is again a tangent to the circle, which touches the circle at the point C, and this from O, this point is A that has been joined, and this point is B which is also joined. Now what you will do is you have to show that angle AOB, this angle you need to show that this as 90 degree. This we want to show as 90 degree. What you will do here is you will join this, OC will be joined and OC will act as a radius. OP is the radius, OQ is the radius, OC is also the radius. Join OC. Given is XY is parallel to X dash Y dash, and both XY and X dash Y dash are tangents. These are the two tangents, and both the tangents are parallel to each other. Now, to prove, what you have to prove here is angle AOB is 90 degree. This you need to show. And in the construction, what you have done is we have joined OC. OC we have joined here. You will take these two triangles, you will prove these two triangles as congruent. How you will prove them as congruent? As a radius and tangent are perpendicular, in the same manner this OC is also perpendicular. So both the angles are 90 degree. OA, OA is common. This line is common. These two angles are 90, and this is equal to this thing, because these are the radii of the same circle. So in the proof, we will consider in triangle AOP and triangle AOC, angle P is equal to angle C, each 90 degree. OP is equal to OC, radii. And OA is equal to OA, common. So this implies triangle AOP is congruent to AOC by RHS, right hypotenuse side. These two triangles are congruent. So can we say that angle 1 is equal to angle 2? Angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by CPCT? Is it okay? the same manner, if you consider these two triangles, they are also similar. And can we say that angle 3 is equal to angle 4? So similarly, triangle BOC is congruent to BOQ by RHS. This implies angle 3 is equal to angle 4 by CPCT. So these triangles are congruent and angle 3 equal to angle 4. Now we want to show that the sum of 2 and 3 is 90. If I consider all the four angles and we will take the sum as 180 degree, why the sum is 180? Because they are angles on a straight line. So can I write here 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 180 angles on a straight line. Now 1 equal to 2, so 2 ko replace, 1 ko replace karke 2 aa jayega, because we want 2 and 3 but we don't want 1 and 4. So 1 will be removed and 4 will be removed because we want 2 and 3. So 4 will be replaced by 3. So twice of angle 2, twice of angle 3 is equal to 180. 2 plus 3 is equal to 90. This implies angle AOB is 90 degrees. Angle AOB is also, AOB we want to show as, we want to show this as 90 degree. So that's what we have done. Question number 10. In question number 10, prove that the angle formed between the two tangents drawn from the external point to a circle is supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment joining the point of contact. आपको कहता है कि प्रूव करो कि ये जो इन दोनों टेंजेंट्स के बीच में एक्सटर्नल पॉइंट पे जो एंगल बन रहा है वो, और जो एंगल पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट को ज्वाइन करके ये एंगल बन रहा है, प्रूव दीज टू एंगल्स एज सप्लीमेंट्री. So what is given? AB and AC are two tangents. And what we have to show is angle A plus angle O is 180. These two angles are supplementary. We need to show this. Okay. No construction is there because all the things are already given. So what you will do in the proof, as you know that radius and tangent are perpendicular, radius and tangent are perpendicular. This implies angle A is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degree. In ABOC, in this quadrilateral, the sum of all the four angles is 180. A plus B plus O plus C is 360 by angle sum property. And the sum of two angles is 180. A and B is both 90-90 each. So let's substitute the value. So the sum of, here you have to write C because both are radius and tangent, to C will be your 90. ठीक है, तो एंगल A plus O कितना आ गया, 360 minus 180, that is 180. Sum of the two angles formed opposite to each other is supplementary. By the first theorem, radius and tangent both are perpendicular to each other. So this angle B and C both are 90 degree each. And this ABOC is a quadrilateral. So the sum of all the four angles is 360 degree by angle sum property. So I have written the value of B as 90, C as 90. 90 plus 90 is 180. So after subtraction, you will get the sum of these two remaining angles. A and O as 180, that's what we want to show you. हमें यही show करना था ना कि A और O का sum जो है वो 180 है. So that's what we have reached. Okay. Any doubt? Now, question number 11. Question number 11 is, prove that a parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. आपको एक parallelogram है, उसे show करना है कि वो rhombus है. तो मैंने rhombus से ही start कर दिया. Okay. I have drawn a rhombus A, B, C, D. This is your P, Q, R, S. These are the point of contact. And we want to show that this A, B, C, D is a rhombus. What is given in the given part A, B, C, D is a parallelogram which circumscribe a circle. To prove, what we want to prove here is A, B, C, D is a rhombus. We want to show them as this figure is a rhombus. What is rhombus? A rhombus is a type of a parallelogram with adjacent side equal. Rhombus is a type of a parallelogram with adjacent side equal. Parallelogram तो already given है, लेकिन अगर आप सिर्फ इतना ही show कर दो कि इसकी adjacent side equal है, तो we are done. Now what you will do, from the center, you will join this also. You can draw, join this complete diagonal if you want. Now here, as you know that from the external point A, two tangents are there. So these two tangents are equal. Tangent from the external point are equal in length. So you will write here construction joint BD OS OP OA. ये सबको join कर दिए, ठीक है? In the proof, what you will do is tangents from external point are equal in length. So this implies AS is equal to AP. This implies AS is equal to AP. Tangent from external point are equal in length. So these two are equal. So I have given it number one. Now you will consider these two triangles and we will prove them as congruent. In triangle DOS and triangle BOP, angle S is equal to angle P, each 90, radius and tangent are perpendicular. Okay, so radius and tangent are perpendicular. So we have got S and P as 90 degree. OS is equal to OP radii. Next is OD is equal to OB. This is a parallelogram and diagonals of the parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. So diagonals bisect each other. This implies, can you tell the property? Triangle DOS is congruent to BOP by RHS. This implies DS is equal to BP by CPCT. Okay. We have given it as number one. This has two, so add them. Add 1 and 2. AS plus DS is equal to AP plus BP. This implies AB is equal to AD. This implies AB is equal to AD. So parallelogram with adjacent side equal is a rhombus. Parallelogram with adjacent side equal is a rhombus. So it must be a rhombus. Read it out once or twice. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Question number 12. You have given a triangle in which circle is there. A triangle ABC is drawn to circumscribe a circle of radius 4 cm. 4 cm radius hai, and this circle is circumscribed by a triangle. ये जो लाइन है दिस इज डिवाइडेड बाय डी इनटू टू पार्ट्स. दिस इज ऑफ 6 cm एंड दिस इज 8 cm. यू नीड टू फाइंड द साइड ए बी. व्हाट यू हैव टू फाइंड इज यू हैव टू फाइंड ए बी एंड ए सी. यू हैव टू फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द टू मिसिंग साइड्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल. द लेंथ ऑफ दिस साइड इज 14. यू हैव टू फाइंड द रिमेनिंग टू साइड एंड द रेडियस इज गिवन. नाउ लिसन, इफ यू ज्वाइन दिस, as you know that this is, these are the radii, so each will be of 4 cm. Okay, so what we have done is we have joined these and we are going to make some more construction. We will join this line then we will join this line. Can you see that this bigger triangle has been divided into three triangles? 1 2 3 1 2 3. And if you add all these three triangles, that will give you a bigger triangle ABC. So what we are going to do here is we will find the area of the triangle AOB, then BOC, then COA, then we will add these three areas to make the area of the bigger triangle ABC. Now what you will do is the, as you know that B is the external point, so tangent from external point are equal DEF. If this is 6, this is also 6, this is 8, this is also 8. Let us suppose this has x, so this length will be also x. Got it? So whatever I have spoken, you have to write all these details here. Construction, join OA, OB, OC, OD, OE, OF. All these you have to join here. Now, in the solution, what you will do? Tangent from external point are equal. So this implies BF is equal to BD is equal to 6 cm. CD is equal to CE is equal to 8 cm. Let AF is equal to AE is equal to X cm. Okay. Now, the length of AB is X plus 6. BC is 14. And AC is X plus 8. So these are the all three length of the triangle. Can we find the area of the bigger triangle ABC by Heron's formula? Area of triangle ABC, by Heron's formula we are finding. What is Heron's formula? that is under root s, s minus a, s minus b, s minus c. So you will find s, s is a plus b plus c by 2, that is x plus 6 plus 14, x plus 8 by 2. So 2x plus 28 by 2, that is x plus 14. So we have got semi-perimeter as x plus 14. You please all note it down. I have to rub all these. Please note it down. Do you have any doubt in this? Is it clear? तो x plus 14 आपके पास आ गया सेमी पेरीमीटर. नाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ दिस बाय यूजिंग दिस सेमी पेरीमीटर. एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल एबीसी इज अंडर रूट s S under root S S minus A S minus B S minus C. This is x plus 14, and when you will solve this you will get 8, when you will solve this you will get x, and after solving this you will get 6. So that's what you will get here. Now make the factors of this. This that is 2 into 2 into 2. This is 2 threes are, so you will take, I can write the step, 2 into 2 into 2 into x into 2 into 3. So out of these two, you will get 1, 2 out. That is 4x, 3x, x plus 14. So this is the area of triangle ABC. This is the area of triangle ABC. Now, next step is you will find the area of the small triangle AOB, BOC, COE. Then you will add them and you will equate them equal to ABC. So, area of triangle AOB is half into base into height, that is half, base is your x plus 6 and height is 4. So that will be twice 2x plus 12. Is it okay? This we have cancelled out 2. 2 into x, 2x, 2 6 are 12. Next is area of triangle BOC, that is half into base into height, that is 14. Again, area of triangle AOC, that is half x plus 8 into 4. Twice x plus 8, that is 2x plus 16. So, according to question, what you will do, you will add all these small areas and that will be equated to 4 times under root 3x, x plus 14. Both will be equated, and after equating them, you will get the value of x. 2x plus 2x is 4x. This is 26. 26 plus 6, 32, plus 10, 42. Is equal to 4 times under root 3x, x plus 14. Take 4 common, x plus 14, sorry, 14 nahi aayega. Ye divide nahi ho raha pura. Now you will make, you can take 2 common, 2x plus 21 is equal to 2 under root 3x, x plus 14. Now make squaring both sides. After squaring both sides, this is 4x square plus 441 plus 84x is equal to, here we have applied the formula, but after squaring here, it will be 4 and root will be removed. 3x, x plus 14. Okay, multiply this. Okay. So please multiply this. This will be 12x square plus 168x is equal to 4x square plus 441. Plus 84x. Now take the terms to one side. That will be 8x square plus 84x minus 441 equal to 0. So this is the equation. Make factors. Make factors and try to solve it and get the value of x. Time is over. So we will complete this question in the next class. Okay. So you please kindly check out the calculation, whether we have formed correct equation or not. If something, some problem is there, then we will rectify it in the next class. Okay.